Hello everyone! Before we start, I just want to say that this video is a very bold experiment for me, for two main reasons. First of all, it's going to be the first video in English on this channel. Secondly, this video is also entirely animated using Python and Manin, which differs from my usual style of handwritten videos, but I hope you'll like it. And since it's very experimental for me, I would highly appreciate any comments or suggestions, so please, feel free to use the comment section. Now, without further ado, let's now get deep in the subject of this video, which is random graphs and coupling. So what even is coupling? I feel like coupling is one of the most powerful and most elegant techniques of probability, but I also feel like it's never been explained properly on YouTube. Now, instead of giving a general survey of what coupling is, I chose to show it in action in the domain of random graphs, by using it to solve a pretty neat problem in probability. So a random graph should be seen as an excuse to see an example of coupling in action. This video will be divided in three main chapters. The first one will introduce a few prerequisites about graphs, so feel free to skip it if you are already familiar with graphs and the notion of connectedness. In the second chapter, I will introduce the Erdös and Rényi model of random graphs, which is a way to choose a graph randomly, and I will state the main problem of this video. Then in the third section, I will provide the solution to this problem, which uses a very crucial way, a coupling argument, and of course I will explain what a coupling argument means. At the end of the video, I will skim through related topics and I will give a few exercises for you to try your hands on, and I will also give reading recommendations if you want to go further in this subject. And a full problem set is then linked in the video description. I'll talk a little bit more about that later. Okay, so let's get into chapter 1, which is about graph theory. So, I've been talking about graphs for a while, but what even is a graph? Here, I'm not talking about graphs in the sense of graph the function x give x squared, for example. No, this is what we will call a plot, another graph. So what do I mean by a graph? So we start with a set of points that we'll call vertices. Here we go. Then we draw lines that we'll call edges between some of these points. Each pair of different points can either be linked by an edge or not. So this is what a typical graph could look like. Okay, let's now draw a few more of them so that you can see what it's supposed to look like. Okay, there we go. So note that among these graphs, this one has no edges at all. It's called the empty graph on three vertices since it has, well, three vertices. On the contrary, this one has 6 vertices and all the pair of points are linked by an edge in this graph. This makes a total of 6 choose 2 equals 15 edges, and it's called a complete graph on 6 vertices. Okay, a few more prerequisites now. I will just talk about connectedness for graphs. So let's recall what connected means in the context of graph. A graph is said to be connected if you can go from any vertex to any vertex by following only a certain number of edges in the graph. For example, you can check that this graph is connected. To do this, you need to check that for any two vertices, you can find a path of edges linking one vertex to the other. However, this graph is not connected, since none of the vertices on the top part of the graph can be reached from the bottom part by following only edges. Okay, just to be sure we are talking about the same thing, here is another example of a non-connected graph. So why is it non-connected? Well, the vertices in blue cannot be reached from the vertices in red by only following a certain number of edges. Note that, of course, you are not allowed to use the internal crossings of edges to go from one edge to the other. You should imagine that the edges do not cross anywhere. Okay, this is it. This is all we'll need to know about graphs, what a graph is, and connectedness, of course. Right, we can move on to chapter 2, which is about random graphs. Just a little bit of motivation to what we are doing here. Note that, of course, graphs are everywhere around us. Like, you can think about page ranking algorithms, Facebook networks, or even chemistry formulas. Therefore, it makes sense to understand what a typical graph could look like, whatever it means. To tackle this problem, Hungarian mathematicians Erdős and Rényi introduced a model of random graphs, that is, a way of choosing a graph randomly. So let us now see how this process works. start with a finite set of points. The number of points here will be called n. Now for each pair of points, flip a coin. If it lands on heads, you draw an edge between these two points. If it lands on tails, you do not draw any edge. Okay? So for each pair of points, you get a probability p equals 1/2 of having an edge between those two points and 1/2 of having no edges between those two points. Okay, and you do that for all edges independently, of course, so you end up with a randomly generated graph. Of course, you might play the same game with a biased coin, which has probability p, not necessarily 1/2 of landing on heads. Then we get another random process for generating random graphs. And we call this process GNP. N here is the number of vertices that we started with, and P is the probability that the coin lands on heads, that is, the probability that between any two vertices you have an edge. For general P, let us calculate what the probability of getting each graph is. Consider, for example, this graph for n equals 4. We will calculate, as a function of P of course, the probability that GNP is equal to this graph. So for it to happen, we need this edge to appear in GNP. This event, that this edge appears, happens with probability p, so we should add a factor of p. This edge, however, should not appear in GNP, and this event has probability 1 minus p, so we add a factor of 1 minus p. And this one should not appear either, so we multiply again by 1 minus p. This one needs to appear, and this happens with probability p, so we add a factor of p. This one also adds a factor of p, since it appears in g, as well as this one, so we end up with the following formula. Now, of course, doing that same thing for general g, we see that p appears to the power e sub g, which is the number of edges in g, and the power above 1 minus p ends up being the number of pairs of points in g, which are not linked by an edge. That is n choose 2 minus a sub g. We therefore get the following general formula for the probability of a graph being drawn. Note that, of course, it depends on the parameter p and on the graph g. To see how these models differ for varying p, let us randomly generate set graphs for range values of p. There we go. Okay, of course, for p equals 0, we drew the empty graph, and for p equals 1, we drew the complete graph. Let us now take a look at which of these graphs are, for example, connected, say. Okay, the first few ones are not, but from p equals 0.4 onwards, we got connected graphs. You should check for yourself that these are actually connected. Therefore, it seems that if p is large, one has a better chance of drawing a connected graph. It makes sense. If p gets large, then every edge is more likely to appear. So there will be a lot of edges, which can help in some way the graph become connected. So a natural conjecture would be the following. Is the probability that GNP is connected an increasing function of p? Well, it seems obvious that such a thing should be true by the argument we just mentioned. If you let p grow, then you have more edges in total, in general. However, this fact is actually surprisingly hard to prove. And this problem is actually the one that we will tackle today. Okay, so how can we do that? Well, first of all, we should take a look at the plot of this function of p for different values of n. Okay, for n equals 1, well, of course, every graph on one vertex is connected, so we get a constant function equal to 1. It gets interesting for n equals 2. Then the probability that we obtain a connected graph is the probability that the only two vertices of the graph are indeed connected, are indeed linked by an edge. And this probability is p, so we get function p. Still an increasing function of p, of course. Now for n equals 3, we get this plot. Trust me on the computation. Still increasing. And so on. So upon looking at the first few values of n, it looks like our conjecture is true. So let's get to proving it. Okay, we should first try the naive approach to this question. We'll just calculate the probability that GNP is connected and try to take the derivative of this and prove that the derivative is positive. Okay, the probability of a certain graph G to be drawn is this. So upon summing over all the graphs which are connected, we end up with the following expression for the probability of G and P being connected. Since we want to prove it is an increasing function of P, we might try to differentiate it. I'll take its derivative. Okay, there we go. It's a polynomial of P. It's easy. Okay, now it's getting kind of scary, but we need to prove that this thing is positive. Well, of course, p to the something is positive, 1 minus p to the something is positive, but this term can either be positive or negative, depending on p and g. There needs to be a lot of cancellation happening for the whole thing to be positive. So it seems to be quite hopeless to prove from this sum that this thing is positive. So this approach might actually not work, or might not be working as expected. So maybe we'll need a few more ideas. Okay, at that point, you should pause the video and actively try to solve this question. It's a hard one. Now, with that being said, let's get back to the video. The coupling argument. Okay, the analytic strategy hasn't worked out quite well. So, since after all, this is a probability question, we might look for a probabilistic proof. Here is a potential strategy for such a proof. Let us take two parameters, p and q, with p being less than q. We want to prove that the probability that g and p is connected is less than that of g and q. For this, we will construct two random graphs, a and b, such that a has the same probability low as g and p, and b has the same probability low as g and q. However, we will construct these two graphs not independently of each other, but in such a way that if a is connected, then b also is. We say that in that case, the two random graphs are in some way coupled, hence the name coupling. Then if we manage to do so, upon taking probabilities of these two events, we get the following inequality. And since A follows the same law as G and P, the left-hand side is nothing but the probability that G and P is connected. And similarly for the right-hand side. So we get this inequality, which would conclude the proof. That being said, of course, we still need to construct such random graphs A and B for this to work. So let's now get into this construction. We start with a set of vertices. To each pair of vertices, or to each potential edge, the same, we attach a random variable wij, where ij are the two vertices considered. Wij takes a random value chosen uniformly in the segment 0, 1. Okay, let's draw all these values randomly for the sake of this example. There we go. Now, take a parameter p, for example, p equals 1 half. We add an edge between vertices I and j if and only if wij is less than p. Since the wij are random, this gives a randomly generated graph that we call A. This is what it looks like if you let p vary. Note that for every pair xy vertices, the probability that there is an edge between x and y is equal, well, to the probability that wxy is less than p, which is just p, since the value xy is chosen uniformly in 0, 1. And these edges are independent of each other. Therefore, A follows the same probability law as g and p. You should take a moment to convince yourself of this fact, it's important. Okay, now let us construct B. For this, we take just an exact copy of the process generating A, but with another parameter Q instead of P. For the same reasons, B follows the same law as G and Q. Keep in mind that, of course, we use the same random variables Wij for generating A and for generating B. This will be important later. Okay, now assume that P is less than Q. Let's update the animation to match this assumption. There we go. Now, note that every edge of A also appears in B. And this is not a coincidence, it's because if wij is less than p, then it's also less than q, since p is already less than q. Thus, all the edges in A also appears in B, so any path in A joining two vertices still exists in B. So if A is connected, then B also is. Upon taking the probability of these events, we get this. And since A follows the same probability law as G and P, and similarly for B and G and Q, it becomes this. Of course, this was under the assumption that P is less than Q, so we are done. So there you have it, a foolproof of this fact using coupling. In this example of coupling, the two random graphs A and B are the random variables which are in some sense coupled. Now, seeking generality, we should note that we did not use much about connectedness. We only used one thing about it. We used the fact that connectedness is stable upon adding edges. That is, if you add edges to a connected graph, it stays connected. So in fact, we've proven the same fact about any property that is stable upon adding edges. We should therefore update our theorem to the following. We say a property of graph is increasing if it's stable upon adding edges. That is, if a graph satisfies the property and you add edges to this graph, it still satisfies the property. Now, for any n and any increasing property p, the probability that GNP satisfies the property p is an increasing function of small p. That's the theorem we just proved. Again, I'll give a small exercise to apply these same ideas. A graph is said to be planar if you can draw it in the plane without any two edges intersecting. What I'm asking you to do is to prove that the probability that the graph G and P is planar is a decreasing function of P. You should try it, it's really satisfying. Okay, before I leave you, I just want to state a few very beautiful results about random graphs and their connectedness, just to keep you craving for more math content. Remember that we looked at the plot of the probability that G and P is connected as a function of P before. There it is for small values of n. One thing we did not try is to let n grow a little more. Let's do that now. It seems that we get a very steep jump from 0 to 1, which gets closer and closer to the y-axis. Okay, so now let's zoom in and move the center of the plot a little bit to see it more clearly. In fact, it turns out that the jump happens around log n of n, and the right zooming factor to see it is around 1 of n. And this is how we stretch the plot, as you can see by looking under the x-axis. Note that the scale itself now depends on n. Okay, now that we did the stretching, let n shoot up to infinity. It seems that the curve approaches a limit curve. And it's in fact the case. It's a very beautiful theorem of Erdős and Rényi that the limit curve exists and is given by this function, e to the minus e to the minus x. Let's see that for n larger now. If you want a more precise statement of what I just loosely said, here it is. It's a very beautiful theorem, but we won't be able to prove that in that video because it's first of all too hard and too long to do so. But if you still want to do it, I've written a problem set which does exactly that, and you can find it in the video description. Here is one more exercise before I leave you. You just need to combine the theorem of Erdős and Rényi we just saw with the fact that the probability that G and P is connected is an increasing function of P for fixed n. And just to conclude, here are a few references if you want to learn more about this beautiful topic. Now please don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoyed, and I'll leave you with this animation of the construction of a coupling. Thank you very much for watching. See ya!